Hello guys, Fruxus here, and today I have a great news update for you. Essentially, I have everything ready to release an alpha version for you this Saturday. It's still very early, but you can start tinkering with it. NeosVR now supports saving your wards, so when you build something, you can essentially save it and it becomes this ward orb. And essentially the ward orb is just another object in the system, so you can grab it, you can move it around, you can move it from one ward to another, and you can even grab the duplicator tool and duplicate the ward itself, then enter one copy, modify it, save it again, and now we have the original and the copy, modified copy as well. Of course, because it's still very early, I cannot guarantee you backwards compatibility for the wards you create now, but I think it's a very important architectural feature to have in the system. Another big change is that I changed the underlying transport protocol from TCP to one built on UDP, and the great thing is that it supports UDP punch through. It is also integrated with a simple matchmaker, so you can have anyone on the internet join your session, even if you don't have a public IP address or a port open on your router. And last small but quite visible change is that when you switch between wards, the avatar in the ward that you just switched from gets this ghost-like look to indicate to the users that you are currently active in another ward. So let's jump into VR and have a look. So hello and welcome to NeosVR again. So as you can see, I start in the simple home again, but now I have it decorated. I have some stuff here and I even have some wards that I created. But we are going to create a new one, build something simple with my colleague who is going to join, and then we are going to save the world, and I'm going to show you what the system can do. So let's start a new world. Oh, Carol is already here. Hello.
Hello. How are you?
Hello. So can we start building something? Can we, for example, build a house for tigers?
Sure.
So you build the house and I import the tiger.
Awesome.
So
I'll take the duplicator.
Let's find the file. Testing assets, tiger plush, there we go. There we go. I have it much simpler. But I'm actually going to duplicate the tigers, so we have more of them. Yep, okay. Like this. And I can help Carol building the house. So are we going to make it made from bricks or from wood? What is better?
Sorry. I accidentally exited.
Oh, but it's okay. You're here again. So I'm going to help you. I'm going to make it from wood. Do you have glue? I'm going to take the glue.
Yeah.
Good. I'm going to glue it together. Oh, this is going to be a big house.
Yeah.
Let me glue.
Lot of tigers.
Oh, I might need to duplicate a few more. So, how is it going? Ooh.
Let's make it bigger.
Now, this is collaboration. Ah, one tiger is already here. But it's okay, we can
actually
scale
here.
The tigers so it fits. Oh, is this going to be open gate?
Yeah.
Ah, great. So let me glue it together. So, now it should be in one piece. Oh! And you can just make another story.
I just copied the...
Yeah. Can you actually put it on top of this, so it's another story, like...
Oh,
or so it's higher.
It's a good idea.
Yeah. So you can have taller house.
Tigers.
Yeah. There we go.
Is it
yeah, this
straight?
Is okay. Not completely, but...
It's alright.
We don't have rulers here yet, so...
Let me glue
it. It's glued. And maybe some kind of ceiling.
How do you
bring the tigers in? So there's another tiger. And here's another. And to make it look a little bit more like jungle, I'm going to change the ground into using this material. Oops, I hit something physical here. Ah, this is better. There we go. And we have nice enclosure. Let's over the sun, or maybe it could be, maybe it's night time, so, but now we don't see anything, so we have to yell,
I see nothing.
But the tigers are unlit, so they have a benefit. This is good. So, we have our simple enclosure. Let's put some lightning around. Actually, can we, because it's very, very dark, like when I move away from the house, I don't see anything. We can actually do one funny thing, is that we can build a headlight. So
And the way it works is I draw something like this shape. Now I make it much larger and longer. And is this a light? Yeah, this is a light. Actually, I'm going to make a new light. I'm going to make a colored light. There we go. So let's say nice and yellow. There we go. And do you have glue? Oh, there is one glue. And now I'm going to glue it together. You can see now I have lights on a stick.
Like a torch.
Yeah, so I can move it around and illuminate it. Can you actually duplicate? Can you duplicate it, please? So we have two.
Yeah.
Ah, there we go. Great.
I made three actually.
Yeah. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to position it like this on my head, add some glue, glue it together, and now it's head-mounted. Head-mounted light.
Okay. You are like the fish lurking.
Yeah.
Luring.
So I have light.
Other animals.
And two more. I could actually glue it to my controller so I could, but that's going to be excessive. I'm going to put it like this. Oh, this is nice. So we have built We have built a very simple environment. Actually, can I make one for you as well? Can I borrow the duplicator?
Yeah.
I'm going to give you a hat as well. So let's just grab it.
Okay.
Let's just go overboard like this.
Like a UFO.
Yeah. A lot of light. There we go.
Okay.
Now glue it all together.
Okay.
There we go. And now let's put it on your head. I'm going to teleport.
Okay. This will be weird.
Are you ready? Yeah. And there we go. And you can move.
Okay. This is weird. Like, yeah. This should be like really heavy. Like,
yeah, but it's super light.
It's not.
Super
nice.
Light. Yeah, it's
made of graphene.
It uses the newest composite materials, so it's very
nice.
Woo! It looks funny. Yeah, so we have our very simple environment, and now what we can do is I can bring up my world menu. Oh, it's all the way over there. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to save the world. And this is actually going to disconnect both of us, because right now I have coupled the saving and exiting, so...
I'm going to lose my head.
Yeah, you're going to lose your head, because avatars aren't persistent, so they are going to be deleted, but everything else is going to be saved. So when I press save and exit, it's going to exit both of us, and then I will load the world again, and you can join, so...
Okay.
Let's try. So I'm saving. And there we go, and here it is, and you can see I can actually have like a preview, like a world bubble into the world. Right now the avatars are part of the 360 screenshot as well, so I can see Carol's silly hair. Well, not hair. I'm not sure what to call it. But essentially I have the world as a world orb in my home now, and if I want to enter it and start a new server, I just touch it. And you can see it wobbled, and when I like double touch it, I open the world, it loads, and I'm here again, and now Karel can join.
Ah,
yeah.
Hello.
Hello. So, we have a new avatar.
Yeah.
So saving is pretty simple, but what's even cooler, what I'm actually going to show you is, let's make some other modifications. Ooh, these are super shiny. Let's make some
particles.
Yeah, let's make some more modifications. Let's change this environment into a desert. Yeah, let's add some particles. It also looks very nice. And let's move the sun up a little bit. So now the world is modified. And what I can do is when I press save and exit again. So let's actually before I save, I'm going to leave Carol to do some more modifications. I'm going to switch to the simple home. You can see I have the world here, and let me write tigers, there we go. So I'm going to switch back. So Carol made some more modifications, and now, oh, that's a lot of light. That's very bright. That's too bright, actually. Yeah, let's not do it. Yeah, let's not make it over bright. Okay. So anyway, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to save again, and because I opened this word from a word orb, it's actually going to replace the copy, or update the word orb. So I'm saving again. And you can see I have the tigers I wrote, and you can see the word is updated. And I open it. And I'm here again with all the modifications and everything that was changed, and Karel should join as well, I think. Is he joining? Ah, change there the he song. Is.
Ah,
cool. Hello. So this is our favorite word again.
Still here?
But what's most important about this system is that word essentially becomes another object. So what I can do, I can go to the simple home. I can grab this word. I can put it in my clipboard. I switch to the word itself, and I pull it out of the clipboard. And now it's actually the word orb for this word itself is in this word. And because it behaves essentially like an object, I can take the duplicator tool. And now I can actually grab the word and create another copy of the word. So now what happens when I enter one of the words, I actually start another nested word. And I'm going to leave Karel here. Karel can actually make more modifications in this word itself, including the ground.
Yeah.
And I'm going to... So I now entered a copy of this word. Karel is not here. He's in that upper copy. So it's becoming sort of like Inception here. And let me actually shut these off and make some more modifications. So let's make the ground nice and metallic, like this. Ooh, shiny. And let's actually make one of our tigers escape. So he's going to go here. And for some reason, he's going to be much bigger than before. And I think that's sufficient. And when I actually save and exit, I return to the upper word. Karel is still doing modifications, and now I have a modified version of the word, and I have the original as well because I duplicated. And that's the point. The word is essentially just an object. So when I duplicate the object which represents the word, it's like I duplicated the word itself. So now I can actually enter the original, and I have a copy of this word again. But I'm not going to save this. Where's my menu? There it is. I'm going to grab it over here. So I'm just going to close this copy. And I can enter the modified copy as well. And I can exit. So that's it. Words essentially behave like another objects. And before we go, there is actually not that much to show. But before we go, I want to show you another thing. Is Karel, I'm going to start another word. Well, start. I am actually going to load some of my older words. And can you go to the simple home and wait there?
Okay.
And when you see a new word pop in the menu, connect to that word. But stay in this word as well. Just switch.
So I'm switching. So you can see my ghost.
Yeah. Karel is already given the spoilers. So I have the word still running, and I'm going to pick one of these words. Actually, this one is cool. So I'm going to load it. This one might take a while because it is a large model. It should appear soon. Ah, there we go. So it's loading. Ah, there we go. And Karel should join as well very soon. Maybe he's already joining. Like it might take a few seconds to transfer. But you can see I can switch back to the original. Well, original, this word. Oh, and you can see Karel is actually, because he's currently not present in this word, but he's still part of the session, he sort of changed into this ghost-like look. And I'm going to look to the other word. Ah, Karel is still not here. So, I'm going to load yet another word. Let's try this one. This one is super simple. Just when this is from very first test when I tried saving words. Let's switch here. Still nothing. I wonder what is it doing. Nope, not here. Nope. Still not here. I think he's already joined. Huh? His avatar just activated. Ah, there he is. Ah, hello.
Hello.
Yeah, that took a while.
Oh. A lot of stuff here.
Yeah, a lot of stuff. I made some decoration added to the Rotenberg office.
Okay.
River.
Oh.
And yes, River.
Some,
made it.
Some air conditioning.
I'm not sure I would call it that. Or like some bizarre sci-fi stuff. So Karol, can you actually, we have all the worlds running, can you actually switch into the original world, the first one we created, and can actually see that he's going to become like this ghost-like, yeah, there we go. And when I switch back, he's here, yeah, he's here. And I'm going to go back, and can you switch to the world back again? Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yep.
It was instant this time. Yeah.
Yeah, because you didn't have to load all the stuff.
Yeah.
So yeah, you can.
I also made my own world.
Oh, you did.
I call it my world. Yeah, sure.
So can I join? And actually, I want to show you yet another thing. So before I'm actually going to shut my own copy of Neos off, but Karel has his own world running. And another new thing is that you can connect using a screen. It doesn't give you full control. It's mostly for testing, and so people without a headset can participate. But I'm going to show you anyway because it's kind of fun from within VR, especially when you have people within VR and someone joining on a screen. So I'm going to exit my own Neos, and let's close these worlds. I'm going to close this one as well. And let's close this one I'm going to save it so I can keep it. Save and exit. Ah, there we go. I'm going to add it to the collection of my worlds over here. And now when I can see Karol's world, but I'm actually going to exit Neos. So it's going to save my world. So let's put it back where the tigers are. There we go. So let's save it. And now I'm exiting. I'm going to grab the camera, including the battery. There we go. Let's open it a little bit. Oh, works. So you can see me, I hope. And I'm going to start Neos again. And this time I'm going to start it on screen. I'm still using Vive for the microphone. So there we go. It's not very. I hope it works like this. So you can see I have my home here. I can look around, I can fly around, and I can join Karol's orbits. So let's join. Oh!
Hello?
Hello! Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you loud and clear.
So I can fly to Karel.
Huh?
And I can I can steal his stuff.
You are in monitor mode.
Yeah, I'm in monitor.
Nice. Do you know what this is? This is Neos Henge. It's like Stonehenge.
This is going. Oops. I think I got disconnected for some reason. Or maybe I accidentally pressed that. Yeah, I think he exited his world for some reason. Also, in the meanwhile, I can actually load the world we created. Let's double click it. So here it is. Here's all the stuff. Here's the Bezier curve. Karol made. I can actually grab stuff. I can move it around.
I'm back.
Yeah, hello. Yeah, but this is the original world again. You're disconnected.
Okay, Neos hands. Neos Henge crashed.
So
I didn't save it.
He's not going to be historic. So I can grab this stuff. Oops, I can grab this.
At least we have the video.
Yeah, it happens.
Happens.
So I can move stuff, I can scale it, and that's pretty much all I can do. I cannot use any of the tools, I cannot interact with stuff in most meaningful ways, but I can have some very basic interaction with the world. I can get in the way of the particles and redirect them. But it's mostly so people can look at what's happening in the world and communicate, even if they don't have a VR headset. But NEOS is being developed primarily for VR, so it's not a big priority. But the cool thing is that essentially the same mode is going to work later on mobile headsets, like Gear VR. So for example, you can look at something, you can press the touchpad and you can move it around, or you can click on things. For example, when I find this... Oh, here we go. There's a light, so I can turn stuff on and off, and there should be a camera somewhere. Ah, there it is. This is actually something I haven't shown you. This is a very simple camera. It's like a simple device. Actually, can we... Oh, you're making a nice tiger. I need to save this. Can we actually go... I want to go back into VR, but I need to restart NEOS. I'm going to save the world, and can you connect again? So I'm going to save and exit. Is it saving? Oh, there we go. So it's updated. And I'm going to exit NEOS. And start it again for VR. And move the camera. So let's go back. And I enter the world. And there we go. It's loaded. So Karol should join soon. I can see his drawing now. And where did I leave the camera? Ah, there it is. So I'm just going to Karol. Hello.
Ah, there I'm back. It is.
Hello. I'm behind you. Hello. So creepy. Because I actually had to implement the functionality to do the 360 rendering, and in the last devlog I showed you how that can be used to record real time 360 video, but it's also used to create the thumbnails for the world orbs. But I also created just to test the feature, but it's actually quite a cool thing on itself. I created this simple object. This is essentially a very simple photo camera, and when I touch it, it starts flashing. Karol, can you look over here? Karol, hello. Yeah. Photo, but and nice. it made a 360 photograph.
That's really funny.
Yeah, and you are here.
Looks like a mouse. Yeah.
So it's super simple, but it's sort of cool, like having some simple virtual device in virtual reality. And especially in NEOS, this is one of the primary concepts. Everything becomes an object. Everything becomes a device. Everything becomes a thing instead of some kind of abstract user interface. And what's even cooler is that compared to real reality, you can actually, let's say you have expensive 360 camera to take photos, but you wanted three for some reason. In reality, you would have to actually buy three, but here I can just grab it with the duplicator. I can actually grab it with the duplicator and just make as many copies as I want. And now they are all essentially independent. So Karol, can you look over here? I can turn all the cameras on and I can do stuff. They are taking series of photos. And there we go. And you can actually see the cameras can even see each other, so some are already making photographs.
You can see the photos in the photos.
Yeah, and this photo is just being made or loaded. So that's a super cool thing, is that you can actually duplicate the devices themselves. Oh, how you photograph? Oh, no, it's going to kill me.
Surprise photo.
Yeah, I think I'm very close. Yeah, you're making photos again. And what's even cooler is that you can sort of simulate some things, like if I go over here, I just grab one of the cameras and it's making photo again. So I make a photo. So it makes a photo. I put the camera in the photo. I make another photo. And there we go. So it took a photo of a photo. I enlarged the photo and I repeat. and you can already start seeing some quality degradation. It's sort of like the guy on the YouTube who uploaded a video on the YouTube and then downloaded the video and uploaded it again and did it like 1,000 times, and you can see how by constant lossy compression it kept degrading in quality. Yeah, so you can already see it's starting to getting a little bit blurry. But I'm not actually going to repeat it 1,000 times here, but technically you could do it. You could have fun like that in NEOS. I think it's getting clogged with photos here already. Yeah, so I'm going to enlarge
I'm looking forward to clog my family with photos and balls.
So let's grab two copies. I think this is more a recent one. Yeah, so let's compare these two, for example. So here I have the original, and if I pull this one in, you can see that it's getting pretty blurry.
Much blurred.
So
much
blurred. You could do that with NEOS itself, like from within VR. So that's mostly everything, and I should have the alpha ready pretty soon. So if you want to start playing with NEOS itself, you're going to be able very very soon. Of course, as you can see, everything is still very developerish, as I like to say. It's still not quite ready, and it doesn't represent what the final product is going to look like, but you can already have quite a lot of fun in NEOS. It's collaborative, so you can invite other people and play with them. And so let's see you with Alpha.
See you later.
And with the next development update. So, bye.
Bye.
Bye. I'm not going to save this one. It's too clogged already.